Hello children and good morning to all of you. Hope you all are fit and fine. You all are aware about the harmful effect of COVID-19, and that is the reason we came to virtual platform to continue your study. I am Ashraf, your chemistry teacher, and today I am just going to start a new chapter, that is classification of element and periodicity in properties. This chapter is not new for you because maximum topic already we have discussed in previous class, that is in class 10. So only if you give a little focus, you can easily understand the thing. So dear children, please concentrate, try to understand. So I'm going to start. Please try to understand. Dear children, can you tell me why? What is the need of classification? Why we are classifying the things? If enough number of things are there, so we need to do the classification. Because if we will not classify the thing, we have to learn the thing individually. We have to gather the information individually. That is not possible. That's why we are doing the classification of the thing. Classification means based on certain common properties, based on certain physical or chemical properties, or any common properties, we are grouping the things together. And if we classify, if we group them, easily we can understand about the group, and also definitely we'll understand each element, each part, each substance of that group. So classification helps us a lot. So that in chemistry also, you all are aware that enough number of elements are there. Some are metals, some are non-metals, some are metalloids. So different varieties of elements are there. That's why we need to do the classification to understand the element properly. In the previous class also, you all have seen that different scientists classified the element based on certain physical and chemical properties. They have done a lot, contributed their contribution, done a lot. So today also we'll go through that, and we'll try to recall, try to understand the things properly. So many scientists have done their concept, even their concept earlier attempt they have made. So we'll start again from the beginning, that is earlier attempts about the classification. The first person was Dobe Reiner. The word you can see, tri means group of three. Three elements are arranged in the order of increasing atomic masses, so that when we will take the average of first and last element atomic mass, we will get the atomic mass of middle element. For example, lithium, sodium, potassium. Three elements are there. Lithium atomic mass is 6.9, this is 39. And when we take the average of this atomic mass, 6.9 plus 39, you will get approximately 23. That is the atomic mass of sodium. This concept is applicable at that time, but it was applicable only to the limited number of tribes. For example, it was applicable to your calcium, strontium, and barium, applicable to chlorine, bromine, iodine. But was not applicable to the enough number of tribes or enough number of elements at the discarded. So, the limitation was there. The next person came after contribution of Dobe Reiner, that was Newlands' law of octave. You see the octave. Octave means the group of eighth one. So he arranged the element in the order of increasing atomic mass like this. You can see that hydrogen, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen, and finally the next one start with chlorine. So think the concept given by the Newton was that the eighth element repeats the first element. Eighth element repeats the physical and chemical property with the first element. Means that you start with hydrogen is first element, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, then eighth one will be chlorine. So chlorine repeats the chemical and physical property with the first element. Was the concept given by Newlands. Just like saying as a musical note, the eighth one repeats the first one, that's why sometimes it's compared with a musical note. But this concept was valid at that time, but not valid for the entire element present there. Actually, this concept was valid only up to calcium. Prediction from the scientists was that only 56 elements were there in the nature, but definitely you all are knowing that more than 56 element are existing. The concept was not that much 100% right given by the person.
Yes.
That's what discarded. The next person came with this contribution, that is Mendeleev, the most acceptable thing that time. Mendeleev's periodic table, or you can say law. This concept is so applicable, so that the person Mendeleev regarded as father of periodic table. Actually, he gave systematic arrangement of maximum element in his periodic table, and because of that, element means at that time whatever the element were existed got the place in his periodic table. But the basic concept was increasing atomic mass. Arrangement of element were based on increasing atomic mass. He gave the law, that is Mendeleev periodic law, that is properties of elements are the periodic function of their increasing atomic masses. So you can see that increasing atomic masses are also the basis of this arrangement. This is the most important, remarkable achievement of Mendeleev, because all the elements were systematically arranged. And if you see, because already topic we have discussed, enough gap were there in this periodic table. If gap were there, definitely the newly discovered element can occupy that gap. So this way is a future plan table, you can see. Clear? But still, so many limitations were there in this table. The first most important limitation was that if no concept of isotope was there. For example, suppose if anyone has to place hydrogen in the periodic table, the three place he has to be. How? You see that hydrogen, three isotopes are there. One, atomic mass. First hydrogen 1, atomic mass, second hydrogen is 2, atomic mass of third hydrogen is 3. So, if you consider atomic mass, we have to give the 3 place for a single hydrogen. That is not possible. So, concept of isotope was not there in Mendeleev periodic table. That was one of the limitations. Okay? But still, it was the most important table given by Mendeleev. After that, the new table came, most acceptable table came, and that is modern periodic table. Modern, or you can say long form of periodic table. Concept is not now about atomic masses. The concept is atomic number. Means physical, modern periodic law is physical and chemical properties are the periodic functions of increasing based on atomic masses, it is based on atomic number. So what were the problem that we are or limitation was getting in Mendeleev periodic table? It is now removed by introducing only atomic number. Clear? So you can see that this is our modern periodic table, and in this modern periodic table, enough number of elements are there. Down you can see lanthanide and actinide series are there. Here is your groups are there, periods are there, means all the elements are systematically arranged. Some are first group is your alkali metal, second is alkaline earth metal, like this is your group number 18, that is noble gases are there, inert gases are there. So in this way, this is very important contribution done by Henry Moseley, and you can see also from our this table that you can see that elements are arranged in a proper way. In the first period, you can see that two elements are there, one and one. Two elements are there. In the second period, you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 elements are there. In third period, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 period elements. It means that there is certain numbers. Let me explain you. And groupwise, I am trying to explain you. Suppose period, I am writing and making it clear. Period, first period, number of elements. Suppose first period, two elements are there. Second period, again, eight elements are there. Third period, eight elements are there. Fourth period, 18 elements are there. Fifth period, again 18 elements are there. Sixth period, 32 elements are there. Seventh period, 32 elements are there. So the number that we are getting, that is called magic numbers in the periodic table. In the modern periodic table, these numbers are said to be magic numbers, because after this periodic repetition will be there. There will be repetition of physical and chemical properties. Like this, let me explain you. You see, suppose for lithium is your first element, then helium is your second element, again the third, after second one, the lithium comes just after hydrogen. Hydrogen is not alkali metal, so if you want to start with lithium, it will be better that suppose the second period, you can see 8 elements. So you can see in this way that second 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. After 8, sodium is coming, that is just after neon, the sodium is coming just below your lithium. So the properties of lithium and sodium resemble that, because they are passed at the same group. That's why they are called magic number. So two element, in the first period two element, eight, second eight, like this, elements are present. So, this is the classification of modern periodic table. You can also see one more thing that is very important, that this is, now you can see that we have six period, after atomic number 56, 57 is start from down. It is lanthanide series, and in period number 7 you can see that after atomic number 88 there is another series given, that is actinide series. So the lanthanides belong to period number 6 and actinides belong to period number 7. So dear children, today we have discussed the classification in a proper way, and try to revise, try to learn, try to recall your memory and try to understand properly. And in the next video, we'll try to find out how to write the exact position, how to find out the exact position of any particular element in the periodic table. So try to learn. Thank you to all of you.